Good morning, good afternoon, good evening. Hey, welcome back to another Filling Station service. I'm your host, Pastor Matthew, and I'm super excited as today we take off into another lesson of our Into the World series. It's going to be an awesome adventure today. So here to get you started with today's lesson is Vance the Vlogger to tell you what's up.
Hey, kids, Vance the Vlogger here, ready to tell you what's up. Today, I am out in Antarctica, and it is freezing out here. But today we're talking about how we shouldn't give up. And you know, I wanted to go on this mission to go around the entire world, and so I had to visit even the tough places. And today we're talking about how Paul, he never gave up because God gave him a mission and he made God master over his life and said, I'm going to follow God no matter what. When he went into Corinth, he told people about Jesus for a long time and God kept him safe through it all. And that's because Paul made God master over his life. So anytime, and I mean anytime, someone asks you, what's up? You tell them, God is my master. Stand up and say it with me. 1, 2, 3. God is my master. All right, Vance the Vlogger here. I'll see you next time.
All right, who can tell me what's up? That's right. God is my master. Today we're talking about how Paul, when he was going around and telling people about Jesus, he followed God no matter what. No matter what happened, Paul made himself a servant to God. He let God be his master over every decision that he made. And whatever God asked him to do, he trusted and he followed him. Today we're going to talk about how Paul ended up in Corinth and how God had told him to go and preach the gospel and that he wouldn't get harmed. Even though people were making threats, even though people wanted to get rid of Paul, Paul listened and he followed the number one. He followed God, his master. I want you to try something out with me today. I want you to stand up. We're going to play a quick game of Jesus Says. I want to see if you can keep up really fast. So this is a really simple game. So I'm going to say, Jesus says, hands on your head. There you go. Pretty easy. You put your hands on your head. Jesus says, hands on your shoulders. Then you move your hands to your shoulders. You're doing great so far. Jesus says, hands on your elbows. All right, you're doing good. Hands on your head. Now, you didn't want to put your hands on your head because Jesus didn't say so, all right? That was our warm-up. Are you ready? We're gonna get going here, okay? Jesus says hands on your head. Jesus hands on your shoulders. Jesus hands on your elbows. Jesus hands on your head. Jesus hands on your shoulders. Jesus hands on your elbows. You got it? All right, we're going to move on to a much faster round. Hands on your head. If you put your hands on your head, you are out, okay? All right, ready? Jesus says hands on your shoulders. If you didn't put your hands on your shoulders, you are out, all right? Jesus hands on your shoulders. Jesus hands on your head. Jesus hands on your elbows. Jesus hands on your head. Jesus hands on your elbows. Jesus hands on your shoulders. Jesus hands on your head. Jesus hands on your shoulders. If you went to your elbows, you are out. All right, let's do one more really quick round here, okay? Jesus hands on your nose. Jesus hands on your head. Jesus hands on your shoulders. Jesus hands on your ears. Jesus hands on your elbows. Jesus hands on your shoulders. Jesus hands on your head. Jesus hands on your shoulders. Jesus hands on your head. Jesus hands on your shoulders. All right. Well, hopefully you stayed in. You made it the whole time. You see, sometimes it can get tricky. When we're following Jesus, if you were watching me, I might have made the wrong move there. And that's why it's important to listen to what Jesus says. And so today we're talking about how God is the master of our lives and how we want to follow what he says no matter what. We don't want to follow what others are doing. We don't want to follow when others tell us what to do. Instead, we want to follow God and make him master of our lives at all times. Let's pray. Jesus, I thank you for this time that we have together today in this service. I ask that you would speak to each and every one of us. Help us to make you number one in our lives, the master of our lives, and that we would follow after you no matter what, no matter what you may call us to. Help us to trust in you and your holy name. We ask that today. Amen. All right, this is our fourth week working on this memory verse, so hopefully you've got it down by now. Sing it if you know it.
Who else? No one else. Who else? No one else. Who else? No one else. Who else? No one else.
There is salvation in no one else. God has given no other name under heaven by which we must be saved. Acts 4:12. There is salvation in no one else. God has given no other name under heaven by which we must be saved. Acts 4:12. There is salvation in no one else. God has given no other name under heaven by which we must be saved. Acts 4:12. Yeah.
Who else? No one else. Who else? no one else. Who else? No one else.
There's salvation in no one else. Acts 4:12, NLT.
All right, let's say that verse together one more time. It says, there is salvation in no one else. God has given no other name under heaven by which we must be saved. Acts 4:12. You see, boys and girls, today we're talking about how Paul made God master over his life. And God called Paul to do some pretty crazy things. He was arrested time and time again. He was beat up. There was one point where he was actually left outside. They thought that they had beaten him to death. And then he actually got back up and went back into the city and continued to tell people about Jesus. Paul, he was committed no matter what. And the reason why is because he knew what this verse said. It says, there is salvation in no one else. God has given us no other name. Paul knew that in order for people to be saved from their sins, they need to know who Jesus is. And he said, God, I'm going to make you master over my life, and I'm going to follow you no matter what. Even if it gets me hurt, even if people look at me funny, no matter what, I'm going to follow after you and tell people about you my entire life. And that's exactly what Paul did. And the Holy Spirit was right there with him the entire time. Let's think about that as we go into this time of praise and worship.
And I need you to stand up for today's worship warm-ups. Now, we're going to start with our hands in the air, and we're going to wave them like we just don't care. Now, we're going to touch our toes all the way down. And now, we're going to do 5 jumping jacks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. All right, you're ready to worship Jesus today.
The praises of our God. There's nothing.
All right, who can tell me what's up? That's right. God is my master. Today we are learning about how God should be the master over everything in our lives. But let's open our Bibles to Acts 18, and while you're turning there, I want to talk to you about what a master truly is. How many of you know what it means to be like the master of something? It means to know like everything about it or be the best at it, right? So I could be the master of Mario Kart if I knew all of the shortcuts, the best racer, the best car, and I always won. I never lost a race. That would make me the master of Mario Kart. And that means that I'm always gonna win, and that means I'm in control every single time that I play that game. It means I am the master of it. Well, maybe another example of a master, have you ever seen the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles? How many of you know who Master Splinter is? Master Splinter, he trained all of the Ninja Turtles and raised them and taught them exactly how they could be those excellent Ninja Turtles that they are, and that they save the world time and time again. And it's all because they were following Master Splinter. Well, it's the same thing in our lives. You see, God is the master over the entire universe. He knows everything about it. He created it. He keeps everything in order. He does everything that he needs to take care of the universe. God is the master over everything. And it's important to remember that we can also make God master over our lives. You see, God created each and every one of us with a special and unique purpose. And it's important that we follow after him no matter what. If we make God number one in our lives, and we say, you know what, I'm going to serve him. I'm going to let him be my master. He will take care of you no matter what. Sometimes people, when they think of servants, they think that's a bad thing. However, here's the one thing I know about serving God. To be a servant of God means that you have the creator, the master of the universe taking care of you. You have the master of the universe watching over you. I don't know about you, but I want the person taking care of me to be the top dog, and that is who God is. So God is the master over everything. And you see, we have an example in Acts chapter 18 of Paul, who made God master over his life, and he followed God no matter what. However, as Paul, he went to Corinth, and while he was there, he met a couple friends named Priscilla and Aquila. And he began to tell them about Jesus, and they were really excited, and they were going around, and they were telling people about Jesus. The message was spreading, right? So Paul made new friends, and then they began to tell people about Jesus. Everything seemed like it was going to plan. So of course, why wouldn't Paul want to follow God and make him master over his life? Everything was working out. However, as Paul continued to preach, there were a lot that wouldn't listen to him. This made Paul really upset. And the Bible says that when the people wouldn't listen to his message, Paul was just trying to help them see that Jesus could save them from their sins. And when they wouldn't listen, Paul shook the dust off his feet and told them that it's their own faults that they aren't saved, because the message of Jesus is for everyone. And Paul, he had to move on. See, this is where things weren't going so well. So he moved on, but he found a different group of people. He went and began to talk to the Gentiles. And the Gentiles oftentimes were considered unclean by the Jews, the people that believed in God. And so there were a lot of times that they wouldn't even associate with them. But Paul began to talk to them about Jesus. And guess what? They began to listen. And day after day after day, people were beginning to believe in Jesus. And it's all because Paul made God master over his life. He didn't give up. He continued to tell people about Jesus. Unfortunately, though, people kept getting angry, and they wanted to get rid of Paul. And I bet that there were times that they made threats to Paul. They probably did all these terrible things, and this wouldn't be the first time Paul's gotten in trouble for telling people about Jesus. But here's what the Holy Spirit said to Paul one night. It says in verse 9, "One night the Lord spoke to Paul in a vision and told him, 'Don't be afraid. Speak out. Don't be silent, for I am with you, and no one will attack you or harm you. Many people in this city belong to me.' So Paul stayed there for a year and a half teaching the word of God. Paul was able to tell people about Jesus and be safe for a year and a half. Now, this was after he had already been beaten before, he'd been thrown in prison, and the Holy Spirit said, 'Paul, I want you to keep doing it, and I will protect you.' And the Holy Spirit did exactly that. Paul survived an entire year and a half without getting in much trouble, but that didn't mean that people didn't still want to get rid of Paul. So here's what happened. Trouble finally came. They brought Paul, they got a new governor in this area, and they brought Paul before the governor, and they wanted to get rid of him. They wanted Paul to be punished. So they brought him before the governor. Now, this was probably a really scary situation. At this point, you would think, okay, maybe Paul would give up and be like, you know what? I'm not going to do this anymore. I don't want to get into trouble. But here's what happened. They brought Paul before the governor. And just as God, the master, promised, he protected Paul. The governor looked at Paul and looked at the people and he said, I'm not going to punish him. He said, all he's been doing is telling people about Jesus. He said, speaking words isn't a crime. And he said, I'm not going to punish him just for talking. And so he let Paul go, and Paul was completely unharmed that day. You see, God was the master over Paul's life, and Paul knew that he could serve him no matter what, and that the Holy Spirit would watch over him. And I want to challenge you today. Will you let God be the master over your life? Will you choose to follow him no matter what? Will you follow him through the tough times and follow him even when it gets difficult and people begin to question who you are and what you're doing? Will you make him number one in your life and follow him no matter what? Have you made God master over your life today? Let's think about that as we pray. Father, I ask that you would help each and every one of us to make that decision today, to say, I'm going to serve you no matter what. I'm going to become a servant of God, and I'm going to serve you and make you my master and allow you to guide my life, because I know that you'll take care of me and that you are in control of all things. I love you, Jesus. I thank you for all that you do for us. Amen. All right, thanks for tuning in for another week of our Into the World series. We'll see you next time.